Hi guys, welcome back, and I hope that you've been enjoying the series of Dear Rosalie. We are now in the 1960s, and in fact, we are finishing up the 60s. The last time we left off, who I believe is Rosalie's daughter, who is in the Air Force, was in Jacksonville, and now she is going to be in San Francisco, and the Vietnam War is sort of ramping up. We have some air mail. Let me can show that to you a little bit more. Just trying not to get their addresses. Air mail. And then this appeared, the Conrad Hilton, Chicago, Illinois. It's post-dated Chicago, Illinois, May 1968. It says, all rooms air-conditioned for your year-round comfort. Yes. Okay. And it is on the letterhead. The Conrad Hilton. Dear Rosalie and family. Well, here we are. We left a lot sooner than Monday. We had hoped to spend the holiday of Mother's Day with our beloved kitties, but it was almost impossible. It's terrible when you're a money monger like me. We were with your very dear friends, Dr. G and his lovely wife, Rose. They were absolutely wonderful. Honestly, they literally rolled out the red carpet for us, and we had a very lovely time. I never enjoyed anyone so darn much other than you, lovely people, as they. Dr. G is a fantastic doctor. He is most dedicated to his profession, and I was never so much impressed with anyone taking his career of saving people's lives as this guy. He is most successful out here and loved and respected by all. You'll never guess what happened. I guess he noticed Nick's eating habits as well as characteristics along with certain symptoms and immediately pushed him into the hospital Sunday night. Imagine. Monday morning, x-rays were taken of Nick's stomach and an ulcer was located. Nick is now doctoring and caring for himself. He wanted him to stay in the hospital, but that was an impossibility. We are now contemplating on the future diagnosis through this wonderful doctor. Well, that's very cool. Being so impressed with him, I related to him my back problem. And tomorrow I go in for x-rays of the spine. Wow. So, finally, after all this coaxing, pushing, encouraging, begging, pleading with big boy Nicky, we finally got to the bottom of the situation. I told the doctor he performed a miracle. He did, too. Nick's on a severe diet. We're having a most productive time out here. I guess so. It certainly was necessary to come out here to keep contact as well with certain contacts and friends. Interesting. We're going to a formal affair tonight, and it should really be the Ritz of times. Oh, the Ritzy of times. No, that's Ritz. Calm down. Dear lovely people, Rosalie and husband, please forgive me for not getting the flowers out to your friend who was in the hospital. I feel like I should be hung at dawn. I really feel badly about it. I couldn't help it. After being with you last Sunday for that marvelous dinner, I was dead set on getting the order for the flowers out the following day. Monday, do or die. Business took it right out of my head, as well as my house was turned upside down the whole week through by rug shampooers, painters. Plus, I was in New York Thursday, Friday, and Saturday. Was making immediate preparation to fly to Chicago. I felt badly for Auntie. She had plans because of the Mother's Day weekend, for the entire weekend. Because of my need, she most dismayingly had to leave everything go to come over Saturday and prepare to stay with my sweethearts and housekeep my joint. This lady's funny. I had a very tough week that week. Needless to say, I never sent a lousy card to my mother. Saturday night and Sunday all day was filled with business and otherwise, and I failed to call my mom till Monday afternoon. Isn't that terrible? She understood, or so she says. I guess she knows her L by now. At any rate, please forgive me. I'll call you when I get back immediately. Most of all, please know fully that I, as well as Nick, love you both dearly. We'll have lots to tell you when we get back. Rose and G spoke repeatedly about you and how very wonderful you were to them way back when. Your ears should be burning and ringing. They just raved about you. Love you always, Nick and L. That was cute. She sounds like such a fun person. Love it. And yeah, we know Rose and the doctor were given like some financial help at the very beginning. So that made a big difference. All right, what do we have here? We have a little, it's the back of the paper. That's this really pretty effect. Oh, When Your Spouse Is Gone by Irene Steigerwald. Your reaction when you become a widow will determine your attitude toward love and life. Oh boy. All right, let's open this up. This is July of 1968, and her friend sent this in May, so 3 months had passed. Oh, and this is from her daughter. Dear Mom, oh my goodness. Her dad passed. Rosalie's husband passed. Dear Mom, called the other day, but you were out with Jay. Hope you and TJ, S, and F will be coming down to see us. Expected you this weekend, but T said you had other plans. W and I have asked Jay and T to stay with us overnight if they like. We would also like to take S with us for a few days after T and J go back to duty. S probably wants to spend a lot of time with J now. I know the days ahead won't be easy for you, but I think you're strong enough to bear the burden of the future. The two younger ones look to you for strength, love, and support. Our next door neighbor has a little niece, 9-year-old, who is special needs. She is attending a new school out in Trenton. However, from the description I've got of her, F is doing better than she as far as taking care of his needs. You know, I think you have done more as far as training F than any of his tutors or teachers. Enclosed is an article that I found in the Marriage magazine, which we get every month. I thought you might like to read it. W and I will be having some masses said for Dad here in Trenton. Take care of yourself and the children. So, is this another daughter? I'll have to double check. But it's signed M, so did she get married? Wow. Okay. So if that's her, I'll find out. I'll have to look back at one of her last letters and see if that's how she signed it. She might be married now. All right. Next is November of 68. Dear Rosalie, both Jay and I were very shocked with your sad news about F, and we both want to express our deepest sympathy to you and all your children. God's will be God's will be done. That is what we are taught to believe, but it is all very hard to understand for those of us that are left behind here on earth. I know how empty it must all be for you, Rosalie, but you can thank God for the boys at home that will help keep you busy and also give you some direction for your life now. We know how hard it is for you, but we also know you can do it. Our boy is a freshman. Did I just say freshman? Freshman. Our boy is a freshman at school just across the river from you. So someday when we go to see him, we will give you a call and visit with you. So far, he is doing fine. A little homesick at times, but that is to be expected. He likes the school so very much. Our oldest, Kathleen, and her husband have just married with their new home. Oh, moved into their new home next town to us. They were with us for 3 weeks in October while the closing was being prepared. So now P is the only one home and we don't see too much of her. She teaches math at a high school and her out of school time is spent with dates, meetings, etc. Jay and I are both well. We go down to our summer place on weekends that we can get away so we can fish. Haven't caught anything this fall as of yet, but maybe we will yet. Maybe we will yet. I am leaving this open so Jay can add, as I know when he comes in from the office, he will write you. Keep your head up. Keep your head up, Rosalie. All of our love and prayers are with you, Jay. So this is this woman's husband writing a note to Rosalie. Dear Rosalie, when I took Jay up on September 4th to Lafayette, I intended to stop and have him meet F and your family. I was stunned to receive your letter and realize your tremendous loss of F he was a real man. I admired and respected him, and with Jay, you looked forward to again seeing him and renewing our friendship. I am very sorry this had to happen when he had so much to live for. As Jay said on one of our trips up, we will stop and say hello. Aw, that's very lovely for both of the people in the couple to write her a letter. Aw. Now my allergies are going crazy. Actually, they don't stop, but that's okay. All right, so now we have, like 2 weeks later, another letter written on pink. Ooh. Okay, so a couple things fell out of this letter, and I'll show you at the end. Let me read. Dearest Rosalie, just a few lines. I've lost my address book with all of my phone numbers. And so this will have to be mailed. Mom has been in hospital in St. Petersburg for a week now. She has an infected gallbladder. Ooh. I'm still waiting for a phone call from her doctor so I can determine what he is saying. As you know, Mom only half hears what is said. Half hears what is said and imagines the rest. So I have found in the post, it is much less emotion lost in getting the information directly from the source. She has been really sick and I have called her almost every night since she was admitted. According to her, tonight, Thanksgiving Day night, he is thinking of surgery. I'll be calling something brother again as soon as I talk with the doctor. Sent my last letter on. I hope Jay is home by now. I agree. Only where when you have been in this situation can you fully appreciate the despair of another. Z was 16 on October 31st, and she would manage to run away this Tuesday after being severely criticized. She felt unfairly so by her daddy. We were up all night searching nearby apartment hallways under the basement stairwells. Something to find her. She was finally brought home by some very loyal friends of hers. I think that sight was ever more joyous than we thought. She was, I can't read this writing. As E says now, it looks like triangle. That's not it. Trying, but maybe necessary to make him treat her as an adult, but it was a gruesome 22 hours. We're still exhausted, but very thankful this Thanksgiving day. Please don't mention this to my mother, as she totally treats every happening as if it were her own heartbreak. And right about now, I think she needs to save all of her strength for getting well. Remember when my brother B was off to Aunt Betty's? It was over a week before they heard. I can well imagine my dad's feelings now. He was so pale and drawn looking and felt so awful. And we had friends whose 17-year-old son his own life 2 years ago from the pressures of school, social pressures, etc. So my imaginations were running wild. Nuff said, she wrote, apostrophe N-U-F-F. We had Thanksgiving dinner with E's folks this evening as E worked day duty. Z made 2 pumpkin pies. She's all an excellent baker. I'm teaching at a high school this year. After leaving to already take all my personal leave for the year, they may not want me back next year. Have 11 in my nurse's aide group and 11 in my medical assistant group, and they are all seniors. Funny, fun, and exasperating in equal amounts. Must close. Send your phone number on Rose. Love, E and Z. Okay, that was tough at times to read. And so she forwarded, or maybe Rose put this in there, but we have this little envelope and it has a way. There's a little, I know you guys aren't going to be able to see who that is, but we have a little charm. And then we have, this is part of a hospital bracelet. I don't know if Rosalie put this in this envelope for some reason or what, but